This channel has been established for visually impaired people. For the visually impaired people, voice narration and a written expression are also provided for the hearing impaired. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel. Jamaica I.D. Mec. Is an island country situated in the Caribbean Sea, consisting of the third largest island of the Greater Antilles. The island, 10,990 square kilometers, 4,240. Caribbean Kingston is the country's capital and largest city, with a population of 937,700. Jamaicans predominantly have African ancestry, with significant European, Chinese, Hakka, Indian, and mixed race minorities due to a high rate of emigration for work since the 1960s. Jamaica has a large diaspora around the world, particularly in Canada, the United Kingdom, and the United States. Jamaica is a Commonwealth realm, with Queen Elizabeth II as its monarch and head of state. Her appointed representative in the country is the Governor General of Jamaica, an office held by Sir Patrick Allen since 2009. Andrew Holness has served as the head of government and Prime Minister of Jamaica from March 2016. Jamaica is a parliamentary constitutional monarchy with legislative power vested in the bicameral Parliament of Jamaica, consisting of an appointed Senate and a directly elected House of Representatives. A map of Jamaica. Contents 1. Etymology 2. History 21. Prehistory 22. Spanish Rule 1509-16 5523 British Rule 1655-1962. 24 Independence 1962. 3 Government and Politics. 31 Political Culture. 32 Administrative Divisions. 33 Military. 4 Geography and Environment. 41 Flora and Fauna. 5 Demographics. 51 Ethnic Origins. 52 Languages. 53 Emigration. 54 Crime. 55 Major Cities. 6 Religion. 7 Culture. 71 Music. 72 Literature. 73 Film. 74 Cuisine. 75 National Symbols. 76 Sport. 8 Education. 9 Economy. 10 Infrastructure. 101 Transport. 10 11 Roadways. 10 12 Railways. 10 13 Air Transport. 10 14 Ports, Shipping and Lighthouses. 102 Energy. 103 Water Supply and Sanitation. 104 Communication. 11 See also. 12 References. 13 Further Reading. 14 External Links. Etymology. The indigenous people, the Taíno, called it dʒəˈmeɪkə in Arawakan, meaning the land of wood and water or the land of springs. Colloquially, Jamaicans refer to their home island as the rock. Slang names such as jamrock, jamdown, jamding in Jamaican patois, or briefly yaw, have derived from this history. Main article, History of Jamaica. Prehistory. The Arawak and Taíno indigenous people, originating in South America, settled on the island between 4000 and 1000 BC when Christopher Columbus arrived in 1494. There were more than 200 villages ruled by caciques, chiefs of villages. The south coast of Jamaica was the most populated, especially around the area now known as Old Harbor. The Taíno still inhabited Jamaica when the English took control of the island in 1655. The Jamaican National Heritage Trust is attempting to locate and document any evidence of the Taíno Arawak Spanish rule 1509-1655. Further information, Colony of Santiago, Jamaica. Christopher Columbus claimed Jamaica for Spain after landing there in 1494. His probable landing point was Dry Harbor, now called Discovery Bay, although there is some debate that it might have been St. Anne's Bay. Street Anne's Bay was named St. Gloria by Columbus, as the first sighting of the land 1.5 kilometers west of St. Anne's Bay is the site of the first Spanish settlement on the island, Sevilla, which was established in 1509 and abandoned around 1524 because it was deemed unhealthy. The capital was moved to Spanish Town, then called St. Jago de la Vega, around 1534. At present-day St. Catherine. British Rule 1655-1962. Spanish Town has the oldest cathedral of the British colonies in the Caribbean. The Spanish were forcibly evicted by the English at Ocho Rios in St. Anne in 1655. The English, led by Sir William Penn and General Robert Venables, took over the last Spanish fort in Jamaica. The name of Montego Bay, the capital of the parish of St. James, was derived from the Spanish name Manteca Bahia or Bay of Lard, alluding to the lard-making industry based on processing the numerous boars in the area. Henry Morgan was a famous Caribbean pirate and privateer. He had first come to the West Indies as an indentured servant. Like most of the early English colonists, the English continued to import African slaves as laborers in 1660. The population of Jamaica was about 4,500 white and 1,500 black by the early 1670s, as the English developed sugar cane plantations and imported more slaves, black people. formed a majority of the population. The Irish in Jamaica also formed a large part of the island's early population, making up two-thirds of the white population on the island in the late 17th century, twice that of the English population. They were brought in as indentured labourers and soldiers after the conquest of Jamaica by Cromwell's forces in 1655. The majority of Irish were transported by force as political prisoners of war from Ireland as a result of the ongoing wars of the Three Kingdoms at the time. Migration of large numbers Irish to the island continued into the 18th century. Jews were expelled from Spain in 1492 and then forcibly converted to Christianity in Portugal. During a period of persecution by the Inquisition, some Spanish and Portuguese Jewish refugees went to the Netherlands and England, and from there to Jamaica. Others were part of the Iberian colonization of the New World, after overtly converting to Catholicism, as only Catholics were allowed in the Spanish colonies by 1660. Jamaica had become a refuge for Jews in the New World, also attracting those who had been expelled from Spain and Portugal. An early group of Jews arrived in 1510, soon after the son of Christopher Columbus settled on the island, primarily working as merchants and traders. The Jewish community was forced to live a clandestine life, calling themselves Portugals. After the British took over rule of Jamaica, the Jews decided the best defense against Spain's regaining control was to encourage making the colony a base for Caribbean pirates. With the pirates installed in Port Royal, the Spanish would be deterred from attacking. The British leaders agreed with the viability of this strategy to forestall outside aggression. When the English captured Jamaica in 1655, the Spanish colonists fled after freeing their slaves. The slaves dispersed into the mountains, joining the Maroons, those who had previously escaped to live with the Taíno native people during the centuries of slavery. Maroons established free communities in the mountainous interior of Jamaica, where they maintained their freedom and independence for generations. The Jamaican Maroons fought the British during the 18th century under treaties of 1738 and 1739. The British agreed to stop trying to round them up in exchange for their leaving the colonial settlements alone, but serving if needed for military action. Some of the communities were broken up and the British deported Maroons to Nova Scotia and, later, Sierra Leone. The name is still used today by modern Maroon descendants, who have certain rights and autonomy at the community of Acampong during its first 200 years of British rule. Jamaica became one of the world's leading sugar-exporting, slave-dependent colonies, producing more than 77,000 tons of sugar annually between 1820 and 1824. After the abolition of the international slave trade in 1807, the British began to import Indian and Chinese workers as indentured servants to supplement the labor pool. Most were recruited beginning in the 1840s after slavery was abolished, as many freedmen resisted working on the plantations. Many ethnic Southeast Asian and Chinese descendants continue to reside in Jamaica today. Montpelier Plantation, the property of C.R. Ellis, ESQMP, c. 1820. By the beginning of the 19th century, Jamaica's dependence on slave labor and a plantation economy had resulted in black people outnumbering white people by a ratio of almost 20-to-1. Although the UK had outlawed the importation of slaves, some were still smuggled in from Spanish colonies, and directly while planning the abolition of slavery, the British Parliament passed laws to improve conditions for slaves. They banned the use of whips in the field and flogging of women, informed planters that slaves were to be allowed religious instruction, and required a free day during each week when slaves could sell their produce, prohibiting Sunday markets to enable slaves to attend church. The House of Assembly in Jamaica resented and resisted the new laws. Members then restricted to European Jamaicans claimed that the slaves were content and objected to Parliament's interference in island affairs. Slave owners feared possible revolts if conditions were lightened following a series of rebellions on the island and changing attitudes in Great Britain. The British government formally abolished slavery by an 1833 Act, beginning in 1834, with full emancipation from chattel slavery declared in 1838. The population in 1834 was 371,070, of whom 15,000 were white, 5,000 free black, 40,000 colored or free people of color mixed race, and 311,070 were slaves. In the 19th century, the British established a number of botanical gardens. These included the Castleton Botanical Gardens, developed in 1862 to replace the Bath Botanical Gardens created in 1779, which was subject to flooding. Bath Botanical Gardens was the site for planting breadfruit, brought to Jamaica from the Pacific by Captain William Bligh, it became a staple in island diets. Other gardens were the Cinchona Plantation, founded in 1868, and the Hope Botanical Gardens, founded in 1874. In 1872, Kingston was designated as the island's capital in 1945. Sir Horace Hector Hearne became Chief Justice and Keeper of the Records in Jamaica. He headed the Supreme Court, Kingston, between 1945 and 1950. 1951, after Kenya achieved independence, its government appointed him as Chief Justice and he moved their independence. 1962 Main article, Independence of Jamaica. Prince Charles and the Duchess of Cornwall during a visit to Jamaica in 2008. Jamaica slowly gained increasing independence from the United Kingdom in 1958. It became a province in the Federation of the West Indies, a federation among the British West Indies. Jamaica attained full independence by leaving the Federation in 1962. Strong economic growth, averaging approximately 6% per annum, marked the first 10 years of independence under conservative Jamaica Labour Party governments. They were led successively by Prime Ministers Alexander Bustamante, Donald Sangster and Hugh Shearer. The growth was fueled by strong private investments in bauxite, alumina, tourism, the manufacturing industry and, to a lesser extent, the agricultural sector. The optimism of the first decade was accompanied by a growing sense of inequality among many Afro-Jamaicans, and a concern that the benefits of growth were not being shared by the urban poor. Combined with the effects of a slowdown in the global economy in 1970, the voters elected the PNP, People's National Party, in 1972. They tried to implement more socially equitable policies in education and health, but the economy suffered under their leadership. By 1980, Jamaica's gross national product had declined to some 25% below the 1972 level due to rising foreign and local debt, accompanied by large fiscal deficits. The government sought International Monetary Fund (IMF) financing from the United States and others. Economic deterioration continued into the mid-1980s, exacerbated by a number of factors. The first and third largest alumina producers, Alpart and Alcoa, closed, and there was a significant reduction in production by the second largest producer, Alcan Reynolds. Jamaica Mines, Limited, left the Jamaican industry. There was also a decline in tourism, which was important to the economy. Independence, however widely celebrated in Jamaica, has been questioned in the early 21st century. In 2011, a survey showed that approximately 60% of Jamaicans would prefer to become a British territory again, citing as problems years of social and fiscal mismanagement in the country. Government and Politics. Main article, Politics of Jamaica. Further information, Foreign Relations of Jamaica and Republicanism in Jamaica. Inside the Jamaican Parliament. Jamaica is a parliamentary democracy and constitutional monarchy, with Queen Elizabeth II serving as the Jamaican monarch. As Elizabeth II is shared as head of state of 15 other countries and resides mostly in the United Kingdom, she is thus often represented as Queen of Jamaica in Jamaica and abroad by the Governor-General of Jamaica. The Governor-General is nominated by the Prime Minister of Jamaica and the entire cabinet and appointed by the monarch. All the members of the cabinet are appointed by the Governor-General on the advice of the Prime Minister. The monarch and the Governor-General serve largely ceremonial roles, apart from their reserve powers for use in certain constitutional crisis situations. Jamaica's current constitution was drafted in 1962 by a bipartisan joint committee of the Jamaican Legislature. It came into force with the Jamaica Independence Act, 1962 of the United Kingdom Parliament, which gave Jamaica independence. The Parliament of Jamaica is bicameral, consisting of the House of Representatives lower house and the Senate upper house. Members of the House known as Members of Parliament or MPs are directly elected, and the member of the House of Representatives who, in the Governor-General's best judgment, is best able to command the confidence of a majority of the members of that House, is appointed by the Governor-General to be the Prime Minister. Senators are nominated jointly by the Prime Minister and the Parliamentary Leader of the Opposition and are then appointed by the Governor-General. Political culture. Jamaica has traditionally had a two-party system, with power often alternating between the People's National Party PNP and Jamaica Labour Party JLP. The party with current administrative and legislative power is the Jamaica Labour Party, with a one-seat parliamentary majority as of 2016. There are also several minor parties who have yet to gain a seat in Parliament. The largest of these is the National Democratic Movement NDM. Administrative Divisions. Main article, Parishes of Jamaica. Jamaica is divided into 14 parishes, which are grouped into three historic counties that have no administrative relevance: Cornwall County Capital KM2, Middlesex County Capital KM2, Surrey County Capital KM2, 1 Hanover Lucia. 11 Kingston Kingston 25 2 St. Elizabeth Black River 1212 7 Manchester Mandeville. Montego Bay. 14 St. Thomas Morant Bay 743 5 Westmoreland Savannah Lamar. Traditions once chosen, officer candidates are sent to one of several British or Canadian basic officer courses depending on the arm of service. Enlisted soldiers are given basic training at UP Park Camp or JDF Training Depot, Newcastle, both in St. Andrew as with the British model. NCOs are given several levels of professional training as they rise up the ranks. Additional military schools are available for speciality training in Canada, the United States and the United Kingdom. The JDF is directly descended from the British Army's West India Regiment formed during the colonial era. The West India Regiment was used extensively by the British Empire in policing the Empire from 1795 to 1926. Other units in the JDF heritage include the early colonial Jamaica Militia, the Kingston Infantry Volunteers of World War I and reorganized into the Jamaican Infantry Volunteers in World War II. The West Indies Regiment was reformed in 1958 as part of the West Indies Federation. After dissolution of the Federation, the JDF was established. The Jamaica Defence Force JDF comprises an infantry regiment and reserve corps, an air wing, a coast guard fleet and a supporting engineering unit. The infantry regiment contains the 1st, 2nd and 3rd National Reserve Battalions. The JDF air wing is divided into three flight units, a training unit, a support unit and the JDF air wing National Reserve. The coast guard is divided between seagoing crews and support crews who conduct maritime safety and maritime law enforcement as well as defence-related operations. The role of the support battalion is to provide support to boost numbers in combat and issue competency training in order to allow for the readiness of the force. The 1st Engineer Regiment was formed due to an increased demand for military engineers, and their role is to provide engineering services whenever and wherever they are needed. The headquarters JDF contains the JDF commander, command staff as well as intelligence, judge advocate office, administrative and procurement sections. In recent years, the JDF has been called on to assist the nation's police, the Jamaica Constabulary Force JCF, in fighting drug smuggling and a rising crime rate which includes one of the highest murder rates in the world. JDF units actively conduct armed patrols with the JCF in high crime areas and known gang neighborhoods. There has been vocal controversy as well as support of this JDF role. In early 2005, an opposition leader, Edward Sega, called for the merger of the JDF and JCF. This has not garnered support in either organization nor among the majority of citizens. Geography and Environment. Main article, Geography of Jamaica. Doctor's Cave Beach Club is a popular destination in Montego Bay. The picturesque Duns River Falls in Ocho Rios, Jamaica is the third largest island in the Caribbean. It lies between latitudes 17 degrees and 19 degrees north, and longitudes 76 degrees and 79 degrees west. Mountains, including the Blue Mountains, dominate the inland. They are surrounded by a narrow coastal plain. Chief towns and cities include the capital Kingston on the south shore, Portmore, Spanish Town, Mandeville, Ocho Rios, Port Antonio, Negril, and Montego Bay on the north shore. Kingston Harbor is the 7th largest natural harbor in the world, which contributed to the city being designated as the capital in 1872. Tourist attractions include Duns River Falls in St. Anne, Y.S. Falls in St. Elizabeth, the Blue Lagoon in Portland, believed to be the crater of an extinct volcano. Port Royal was the site of a major earthquake in 1692 that helped form the island's Palisados. The climate in Jamaica is tropical, with hot and humid weather, although higher inland regions are more temperate. Some regions on the south coast, such as the Liguania Plain and the Pedro Plains, are relatively dry rain shadow areas. Jamaica lies in the hurricane belt of the Atlantic Ocean, and because of this, the island sometimes suffers significant storm damage. Hurricanes Charley and Gilbert hit Jamaica directly in 1951 and 1988, respectively, causing major damage and many deaths in the 2000s decade. Hurricanes Ivan, Dean, and Gustav also brought severe weather to the island. Among the variety of terrestrial, aquatic, and marine ecosystems are dry and wet limestone forests, rainforest, riparian woodland, wetlands, caves, rivers, seagrass beds, and coral reefs. The authorities have recognized the tremendous significance and potential of the environment and have designated some of the more fertile areas as protected. Among the island's protected areas are the Cockpit Country, Hellshire Hills, and Litchfield Forest Reserves. In 1992, Jamaica's first marine park, covering nearly 15 square kilometers 58. Areas of heavy rainfall contain stands of bamboo, ferns, ebony, mahogany, and rosewood cactus, and similar dry area plants are found along the south and southwest coastal area. Parts of the west and southwest consist of large grasslands, with scattered stands of trees. The Jamaican animal life, typical of the Caribbean, includes highly diversified wildlife with many endemic species found nowhere else on Earth. As with other oceanic islands, land mammals are mostly bats. The only non-bat native mammal extant in Jamaica is the Jamaican hutia, locally known as the coney. Introduced mammals such as wild boar and the small Asian mongoose are also common. Jamaica is also home to about 50 species of reptiles, the largest of which is the American crocodile. However, it is only present within the Black River and a few other areas. Lizards such as anoles, iguanas, and snakes such as racers and the Jamaican boa, the largest snake on the island, are common in areas such as the cockpit country. None of Jamaica's 8 species of native snakes is venomous. One species of freshwater turtle is native to Jamaica, the Jamaican slider. It is found only on Jamaica, Cat Island, and a few other islands in the Bahamas. In addition, many types of frogs are common on the island, especially tree frogs. Birds are abundant, and make up the bulk of the endemic and native vertebrate species. Beautiful and exotic birds, such as the Jamaican toady and the doctor bird, the national bird, can be found among a large number of others. Jamaican waters contain considerable resources of fresh and saltwater fish. The chief varieties of saltwater fish are kingfish, jack, mackerel, whiting, bonito, and tuna. Fish that occasionally enter freshwater and estuarine environments include snook, jewfish, mangrove snapper, and mullets. Fish that spend the majority of their lives in Jamaica's fresh waters include many species of livebearers, killifish, freshwater gobies, the mountain mullet, and the American eel. Tilapia have been introduced from Africa for aquaculture, and are very common. Insects and other invertebrates are abundant, including the world's largest centipede, the Amazonian giant centipede, and the Homerus swallowtail, the Western Hemisphere's largest butterfly. Demographics. Further information: demographics of Jamaica and Jamaican people. Ethnic origins. Jamaica's population, 1961-2003. The streets of Montego Bay, Jamaica. According to the most recent census, conducted in 2011, the majority of Jamaicans identify as Black ethnic group. 921% mixed, 61% Asian, 08% other, 04% unspecified, 07%. Much of Jamaica's Black population are of African or partially African descent, with many being able to trace their origins to West Africa, as well as Europe and Asia. Like many other Anglophone Caribbean countries, many Jamaicans with mixed ancestry self-report as Black. Asians form the second largest group and include Indo-Jamaican East Indians and the Chinese Jamaican. Most are descended from indentured workers brought by the British colonial government to fill labor shortages following the abolition of slavery in 1838. In recent years, immigration has increased, coming mainly from China, Haiti, Cuba, Colombia, and Latin America. 20,000 Latin Americans reside in Jamaica, about 7,000. Americans also reside in Jamaica, as well as many first-generation American, British, and Canadians of Jamaican descent. A study found that the average admixture on the island was 783% sub-Saharan African, 160% European, and 57% East Asian languages. Main articles: Jamaican Patois and Jamaican English. Jamaica is regarded as a bilingual country, with two major languages in use by the population. The official language is Jamaican Standard English JSE, or Standard Jamaican English SJE, which is used in all domains of public life, including the government, the legal system, the media, and education. However, the primary spoken language is an English-based Creole called Jamaican Patois or Patois. A 2007 survey by the Jamaican Language Unit found that 171% of the population were monolingual in JSE, 365% were monolingual in Patois, and 464% were bilingual. Although earlier surveys had pointed to a greater degree of bilinguality, up to 90%, the Jamaican education system has only recently begun to offer formal instruction in Patois, while retaining JSE as the official language of instruction. Additionally, some Jamaicans speak one or more of Jamaican Sign Language, American Sign Language, or the indigenous Jamaican Country Sign Language, Country Sain. Both JSL and ASL are rapidly replacing Country Sain for a variety of reasons. Emigration. Main article: Jamaican diaspora. Many Jamaicans have emigrated to other countries, especially to the United Kingdom, the United States, and Canada. In the case of the United States, about 20,000 Jamaicans per year are granted permanent residence. The great number of Jamaicans living abroad has become known as the Jamaican diaspora. There has also been emigration of Jamaicans to Cuba. The scale of emigration has been widespread and similar to other Caribbean Caribbean entities such as Puerto Rico, Guyana, and the Bahamas. It was estimated in 2004 that up to 25 million Jamaicans and Jamaican descendants live abroad. Concentrations of expatriate Jamaicans are quite considerable in numerous cities in the United States, including New York City, Buffalo, the Miami metro area, Atlanta, Chicago, Orlando, Tampa, Washington, D.C., Philadelphia, Hartford, Providence, and Los Angeles. Jamaicans in the United Kingdom number an estimated 800,000, making them by far the country's largest African Caribbean group. Large-scale migration from Jamaica to the UK occurred primarily in the 1950s and 1960s when the country was still under British rule. Jamaican communities exist in most large UK cities in Canada. The Jamaican population is centered in Toronto, and there are smaller communities in cities such as Hamilton, Montreal, Winnipeg, Vancouver, and Ottawa. Crime. Main article: Crime in Jamaica. See also: Prisons in Jamaica and LGBT rights in Jamaica. When Jamaica gained independence in 1962, the murder rate was 39 per 100,000 inhabitants, one of the lowest in the world. By 2009, the rate was 62 per 100,000 inhabitants, one of the highest in the world. Jamaica has had one of the highest murder rates in the world for many years. According to UN estimates, some areas of Jamaica, particularly cities such as Kingston, experience high levels of crime and violence. Some Jamaicans are hostile toward LGBT and intersex people, and there have been reported cases of mob attacks against gay people. However, crime in Jamaica has recently shown a downward trend. There were 1,682 reported murders in 2009 and 1,428 in 2010. Since 2011, the murder rate has continued to fall following the downward trend started in 2010, with increases in police patrols, curfews, and more effective anti-gang activities in 2012, the Ministry of National Security reported a 30% decrease in murders. Major cities. VE largest cities or towns in Jamaica. http://ujanamesorg/jm/largest-cities-in-jamaicatmel rank name parish pop Kingston 1 Kingston Kingston 937,700 Spanish Town 2 New Kingston St. Andrew 583,958 3 Spanish Town St. Catherine 145,018 4 Portmore St. Catherine 102,861 5 Montego Bay St. James 82,867 6 Mandeville Manchester 47,115 The 7th of May Penn Clarendon 44,755 8 Old Harbour St. Catherine 26,024 9 Linstead St. Catherine 20,660 10 Halfway, Tree St. Andrew 18,552 Religion. Main article: Religion in Jamaica. Mandeville Church in Manchester Parish founded in 1816. Christianity is the largest religion practiced in Jamaica. Protestants form the majority in the country, and Roman Catholics are a minority 2% of the population according to the 2001 census. The country's largest Protestant denominations are the Church of God 24%, Seventh-day Adventist Church 11%, Pentecostal 10%, Baptist 7%, Anglican 4%, United Church 2%, Methodist 2%, Moravian 1% and Plymouth Brethren 1%. The Christian faith gained acceptance as British Christian abolitionists and Baptist missionaries joined educated former slaves in the struggle against slavery. The Rastafari movement has 29,026 adherents, according to the 2011 census, with 25,325 Rastafarian males and 3,701 Rastafarian females. Other religions in Jamaica include Jehovah's Witnesses 2% population, the Baha'i Faith, which counts perhaps 8,000 adherents and 21 local spiritual assemblies, Buddhism, and Hinduism. There is a small population of Jews, about 200, who describe themselves as liberal conservative. The first Jews in Jamaica trace their roots back to early 15th century Spain and Portugal. Other small groups include Muslims, who claim 5,000 adherents, as do the Mormons. Culture. Main article: Culture of Jamaica. Marcus Garvey, father of the Back to Africa movement and Jamaica's first national hero. Bob Marley, the most famous reggae artist from Jamaica. Music. Main article: Music of Jamaica. Though a small nation, Jamaican culture has a strong global presence. The musical genres reggae, ska, mento, rocksteady, dub, and, more recently, dancehall and raga all originated in the island's vibrant, popular urban recording industry. Jamaica also played an important role in the development of punk rock, through reggae and ska. Reggae has also influenced American rap music, as they share roots as rhythmic, African styles of music. Some rappers, such as the notorious Big and Heavy D, are of Jamaican descent, internationally known reggae musician Bob Marley was also Jamaican. Many other internationally known artists were born in Jamaica, including Millie Small, Lee Scratch Perry, Gregory Isaacs, Half Pint, Protégé, Peter Tosh, Bunny Wailer, Big Youth, Jimmy Cliff, Dennis Brown, Desmond Decker, Barris Hammond, Beanie Man, Shaggy, Grace Jones, Shaba Ranks, Supercat, Buju Banton, Sean Paul, I Wayne, Bounty Killer, and many others. Band artist groups that came from Jamaica include Black Uhuru, Third World Band, Inner Circle, Chalice Reggae Band, Culture, Fab Five, and Morgan Heritage. The genre jungle emerged from London's Jamaican diaspora. The birth of hip-hop in New York City owed much to the city's Jamaican community literature. Main article, Jamaican Literature. Ian Fleming, who lived in Jamaica, repeatedly used the island as a setting in his James Bond novels, including Live and Let Die, Dr. No, For Your Eyes Only, The Man with the Golden Gun, and Octopussy and the Living Daylights. In addition, James Bond uses a Jamaica-based cover in Casino Royale. So far, the only James Bond film adaptation to have been set in Jamaica is Dr. No. Filming for the fictional island of San Monique in Live and Let Die took place in Jamaica. The journalist and author H.G. de Lisser, 1878-1944, used his native country as the setting for his many novels. Born in Falmouth, Jamaica, de Lisser worked as a reporter for the Jamaica Times at a young age, and in 1920 began publishing the magazine Planter's Punch. The White Witch of Rosehall is one of his better-known novels. He was named honorary president of the Jamaican Press Association. He worked throughout his professional career to promote the Jamaican sugar industry. Marlon James, Chapter 1970, novelist, has published three novels: John Crow's Devil, 2005, The Book of Night Women, 2009, and A Brief History of Seven Killings, 2014, winner of the 2015 Man Booker Prize film. See also, list of Jamaican films. The cinema actor Errol Flynn lived with his third wife Patrice Wymore in Port Antonio in the 1950s. He helped develop tourism to this area, popularizing trips down rivers on bamboo rafts. Jamaica has a long history in the film industry dating from the early 1960s. A look at delinquent youth in Jamaica is presented in the 1970s musical crime film The Harder They Come, starring Jimmy Cliff as a frustrated and psychopathic reggae musician who descends into a murderous crime spree. The American film Cocktail, 1988, starring Tom Cruise, is one of the more popular films to depict Jamaica. Another popular Jamaican-based film is the 1993 Disney comedy Cool Runnings, which is loosely based on the true story of Jamaica's first bobsled team trying to make it in the Winter Olympics. Cuisine. Main article, Jamaican cuisine. The island is famous for its Jamaican jerk spice, which is integral to Jamaican cuisine. Jamaica is also home to Red Stripe beer and Jamaican Blue Mountain coffee. National symbols from the Jamaica Information Service. National bird, red-billed streamertail, also called Dr. Bird, a hummingbird. Trachilus polytmus. National flower, Lignum vitae gaiacum officinale. National tree, Blue Maho hibiscus taliparatia latum. National fruit, Aki Blaya Sapita. National motto, Out of Many, One People. Sport. Main article, sport in Jamaica. Usain Bolt at the 2009 World Championships in Athletics in Berlin. Sport is an integral part of national life in Jamaica, and the island's athletes tend to perform to a standard well above what might ordinarily be expected of such a small country. While the most popular local sport is cricket, on the international stage Jamaicans have tended to do particularly well at track and field athletics. Jamaica has produced some of the world's most famous cricketers, including George Headley, Courtney Walsh, and Michael Holding. The country was one of the venues of 2007 Cricket World Cup, and the West Indies cricket team is one of 10 ICC full member teams that participate in international test cricket. The Jamaica national cricket team competes regionally, and also provides players for the West Indies team. Sabina Park is the only test venue in the island, but the Greenfield Stadium is also used for cricket. Chris Gayle is the most renowned batsman from Jamaica, currently representing the West Indies cricket team. Since independence, Jamaica has consistently produced world-class athletes in track and field. In Jamaica, involvement in athletics begins at a very young age, and most high schools maintain rigorous athletics programs with their top athletes competing in national competitions, most notably the VMBS Girls and Boys Athletics Championships and international meets, most notably the Penn Relays. In Jamaica, it is not uncommon for young athletes to attain press coverage and national fame long before they arrive on the international athletics stage. Over the past six decades, Jamaica has produced dozens of world-class sprinters, including Olympic and world champion Usain Bolt, world record holder in the 100 meters for men at 9:58 and 200 meters for men at 1919's. Other noteworthy Jamaican sprinters include Arthur Wint, the first Jamaican Olympic gold medalist, Donald Querry, Olympic champion and former 200 meters world record holder, Roy Anthony Bridge, part of the International Olympic Committee, Merlene Oddie, Delarine Ennis London, Shelley Ann Fraser Price, the current world and Olympic 100 meters champion, Karen Stewart, Aline Bailey, Juliet Cuthbert, Veronica Campbell Brown, Sharon Simpson, Bridget Foster Hilton, Johan Blake, Herb McKenley, George Roden, Olympic gold medalist, Dion Hemmings, Olympic gold medalist, as well as Asafa Powell, former 100 meters world record holder and 2x100 meters Olympic finalist and gold medal winner in the men's 2008 Olympic 4x100 meters. Jamaica has also produced several world-class amateur and professional boxers, including Trevor Burbick and Mike McCallum. First-generation Jamaican athletes have continued to make a significant impact on the sport internationally, especially in the United Kingdom, where the list of top British boxers born in Jamaica or of Jamaican parents includes Lloyd Honeygon, Chris Eubank, Audley Harrison, David Hay, Lennox Lewis and Frank Bruno. Association football and horse racing are other popular sports in Jamaica. The national football team qualified for the 1998 FIFA World Cup. The Jamaica national bobsled team was once a serious contender in the Winter Olympics, beating many well-established teams. Chess and basketball are widely played in Jamaica and are supported by the Jamaica Chess Federation JCF and the Jamaica Basketball Federation JBF, respectively. Netball is also very popular on the island, with the Jamaica national netball team called the Sunshine Girls consistently ranking in the top five in the world. The Jamaica National Rugby League team is made up of players who play in Jamaica, and UK players from professional and semi-professional teams in the UK. Their first international was a 37-22 loss to the United States National Rugby League team in November 2009. Rugby League in Jamaica is growing, with universities and high schools taking up the sport. The JRLA Championship is the main rugby league competition in the country. The Hurricanes Rugby League are a professional rugby league team who are hoping to compete in either the USA Rugby League or the AMNRL by 2013. During that time, they will be training young players aged 14 to 19 who will be part of the Hurricanes RL Academy in the hope of developing into full-time professional players. According to ESPN, the highest-paid Jamaican professional athlete in 2011 was Justin Masterson, starting pitcher for the Cleveland Indians. Education. Main article, Education in Jamaica. The emancipation of the slaves heralded in the establishment of the Jamaican education system for the masses. Prior to emancipation, there were few schools for educating locals. Many sent their children off to England to access quality education. After emancipation, the West Indian Commission granted a sum of money to establish elementary schools, now known as all-age schools. Most of these schools were established by the churches. This was the genesis of the modern Jamaican school system. Presently, the following categories of schools exist: early childhood, basic, infant and privately operated preschool age cohort, 2 to 5 years primary, publicly and privately owned. Privately owned being called preparatory schools, ages 3 to 12 years secondary, publicly and privately owned ages 10 to 19 years. The high schools in Jamaica may be either single-sex or coeducational institutions, and many schools follow the traditional English grammar school model used throughout the British West Indies. Tertiary, community colleges, teachers' colleges, with the Miko Teachers College, now the Miko University College, being the oldest, founded in 1836, the Shortwood Teachers College, which was once an all-female teacher training institution, vocational training centers, colleges and universities, publicly and privately owned. There are five local universities, namely, the University of the West Indies Mona Campus, the University of Technology, Jamaica, formerly the College of Art, Science and Technology CAST, the Northern Caribbean University, formerly West Indies College, the University College of the Caribbean and the International University of the Caribbean. Additionally, there are many community and teacher training colleges. Education is free from the early childhood to secondary levels. There are also opportunities for those who cannot afford further education in the vocational arena through the Human Employment and Resource Training National Training Agency Heart Trust NTA program, which is open to all working age national population, and through an extensive scholarship network for the various universities. Students are taught Spanish in school from the primary level upwards. About 40-45% of educated people in Jamaica knows some form of Spanish. Economy. Main article, Economy of Jamaica.